We are welcome again to another, the week ended March 8, 2019. The market for the week ended March 8 was a mixed market from the performance of the market. We have 3 days of loss position and 2 days of uptrend, or 2 days of bear of bull market. Let me use that language. And if you look at the market performance for this period that we are looking at, you see that the big caps or highly capitalized equity released their number within this period, and the market did not respond to these numbers. You ask why? I will tell you that why the market did not respond was because there is liquidity problem in the market already, and at the same time, the dividend compared to the price of these equities are too low, which the dividend yield have reviewed. The dividend yield of these companies are low. And for me as an investor, I would advise that this kind of stocks that are selling at this high price, paying this mega dividend, is not a place to be. But for those that want to play a defensive stocks, can still look at them, because stock like Nestle, stock like Steplat, stock like Stanbic IBTC and GTB, these are defensive stocks, and what these are the highly capitalized stocks on the exchange. But their numbers as made available last week were not too impressive, and it was below market worth expectation, and the market responded in the same direction. Yes, there's no liquidity in the market, but I'm telling you, if these numbers were better than this, we are seeing markets struggling to make that these stocks look up, but they didn't. They all just drag feet, and for you know, they are all looking down. Especially the stock like Nestle. Nestle was the one I said, if not for loyalty, that consumer they have, that number is nothing to me. And also, it is only this same company, Nestle, and Unilever, that were able to grow their sales for 2018, and we can't take away the companies from the economy where they're operating. Yes, you know that the economy in 2018 was also a sluggish one, making one step forward and a step backward. That was what we saw in 2018, and it reflected on especially the food and beverages. It tells you that the purchasing power of many Nigerians has gone below expectation, that these goods coming from this company, we are still on the shelf. But what others like Nestle and the Unilever, because of the multiple product line and those their cash cow products, we are also making little way for them to post the most marginal increase in their sales, which is good. But if you look at the number of Nestle, and the company is paying you dividend of a total dividend of 58 naira 50 kobos, and not only that, the full year earning per share for this company was 54 naira 20 kobo, and they have to go back to their 2009 account to take 4 naira 20 kobo to complete the payment of 58 naira 50 kobo dividend. It tells you that the company has struggled for the period, and also because of the price, they want to pay something level to the price, but you can see that there is still margin. It's still like selling for 1,510. Giving a dividend of it does not the dividend yield is less than 4%, if not, it's up to less than 4% or 3%. Also, look at the stock of the same stock there, it's still going to go for Steplat. Yeah, Steplat are paid interim like the way the Nestle are paid interim of 20 naira before this final. Steplat are paid in a different ranges of dividend from first quarter to second quarter, but the final they are paying is 5 cents. When you compare that, it's about 15 naira, 19 naira. And compared to the price is selling and that, you know, as it's also that the dividend yield is high. And also the number coming was not too impressive. They posted a loss, and this loss emanated from the accumulated tax that was paid that had to put the account in red. But for me, all these stocks are high for the dividend they are paying. They are high. Their prices are high compared to the dividend they are paying. For me, there are also some blue chips companies and growth stocks that have potential to grow and can give you some more better dividend. But for those I said earlier that are paying dividend stock, you can still look the way of this stock. Then we leave that, we'll go to GTB and Stanbic. Because Stanbic is selling for about 47 naira, 48 naira, and it's paying a final dividend of 150 kobo in addition to 1 naira paid earlier interim, that is 250. And GTB is paying 2 naira 45 kobo compared to in addition to 30 kobo interim paid earlier, that is a total of 2 naira 75 kobo. Why is it bad that it's selling for 25 naira? It's giving you a dividend of 2 naira 50 kobo in addition to earlier 30 kobo, that is 280. As an investor, which of these stocks should you position and take your dividend? If you buy Zenith Bank, you get more dividend. If you buy GTB, you get less dividend compared. For example, if you are investing 1 million naira, take 1 million naira to Zenith Bank and buy about, let's say, for example, 50,000 units of, or 40,000 units of Zenith Bank. That will give you almost 100,000 naira dividend. And use the money to buy that of GT. No, but now that there's no liquidity in the market, I think the best strategy the market should go, or investors should adopt now, is to play the dividend. At the end of the day, as we're expecting government to find direction with their policy, we're expecting government to come out with a policy, because for me, it's a continuity. They don't need to sit down and be looking for, they know where they stop. All they need to do is put the right people in the right place and change their strategy and their governance style to move the economy forward. If that is done very soon, I think it will give the market direction. That means for you, before this thing happened, you can't just keep on and you see this good dividend yield in some stocks and keep quiet. You can play around. If you look at the yield in Africa Prudential, you can go around these stocks and come back. Then at the end of the day, buy a stock that when the market will finally find its direction, you will recover all your money and this dividend, this profit becomes your profit. That's how to invest at this point. Don't think that because there's no liquidity in the market, you should pack your packages and leave the market. No. The same market where you lost money, that's the market you can recoup your money. Now that you have opportunity to play this dividend period, take position and hold your stock. But that you have to use the markdown date, qualification date, and payment date this period, effectively to know when to exit a stock, when not to go. If you have bought earlier and you have made capital appreciation more than what they are paying dividend, you sell off and enter another one. The one you have entered that dividend is okay, you take the mark and you move. On the end of the day, you would have made a good return. That is how to invest today. Why I would say that the momentum in the market has really gone down is because the smart money forecast or projection were missed. What I mean, they were forecasting that this has going to be, and the result of the election go opposite the expectation, that they took advantage of that 3 days delay in announcing the result to dump these shares. And you can see this here. I'm using a daily chart, I'm using a daily time frame to explain. Look at these 3 days. This is where they pull out from the market. They sell massively, and volume was traded these days. For me, whether they move to fixed income or they're holding cash, they are still coming back to the market. They want to watch, and you know that as numbers are not also impressive, they will want to see the end of what the first quarter and see the Q1 number of these companies to give them insight of how 2019 will look like. Knowing that we had a little growth in third quarter and the fourth quarter of 2018, we want to see the performance of the economy in this first quarter. That already today is 10th already. That tells you that this month, in the next three weeks, we're out of March. And April is where we're expecting their first quarter. Then, as an investor, you don't have to time and know when to be the market. Like I always tell people that, go and see the history of the capital market. Capital market perform, the best time to be the market, there is momentum in the market between November and May. And in Nigeria here, it's between November and April. Most time, May is good, but May is okay. But May, I believe that by April, you should have sold down, hold your cash and watch where you are going and come back again to the market. You must not be in stock at all time. That's why you have a different price of investment window to play around with. But I believe that this week we are entering now, we expect more earnings to hit the market, but what we have seen so far have not given us much we are expecting because the numbers were missed. But for me, this is a good time for you to take position in those dividend paying stocks and what and make money for yourself. It's not the time to complain, but it's the time to take position. During the week under review, Women Bank led the gainers chart, gaining 11.69, which is good in expectation of the full year earnings of this company. Then Quitus was the second one there. Quitus gained 9.76, not to close the week in expectation of that. You know that Quitus has April at the year end. We're expecting that third quarter to be in the market any moment from now. The third quarter is already in the market, and the result was also not too impressive because they gave one for one bonus that have, you know, blown their share in issue, and their earnings was not too strong. But because the company has really given direction where they are going, market is responding to that number. But for me, this is a stock you should come back and invest later, play the dividend stock first, and this opportunity you should come. Then the third one on that list was a Sovereign Trust Insurance. You know, this company is gearing up for a right issue, and I know also if you look at all the insurance that are notified the exchange of their late note submission, because the regulator has changed the format of submitting their numbers, their full year results. On that note, we expect that most insurance results will come late this year, especially during the April, which is the first month of the second quarter. We expect their results to be there. For me, if you are insurance stock, how many of them would like you to pay dividend? You should play those dividend stock at this point and take position. Also, have a international brewery on the chart among the gainers for the week. On the flip side, the loser side, Mutual Benefit led the loser chart, losing 14.81, followed by PZ, and these are profit worth taking. Livestock Feed also lost 11.94 to close at 0.95. Academic Press was also on the loser chart. It closed at 0.36, losing 10%. These are how the market performed for last week. But before I run, I want to look at the money flow index. I said this is what you used to know, where the smart money are leaving and when they are entering. When the funds is entering the market or funds is leaving the market, it tells you direction. Look at January 17. Look at, we're having money flow position at 19.8%. Look at during the period, a rally as high as 92.40. It tells you that funds are really entered this market. And when what happened towards the election, you know, some with election, you can see market was flying, price was going up. People were saying, market was defining the election, political tension and all the stuff. It was because this smart money were forecasted, and they're catching on the low price of equity to position that pushed the market up. But when they saw the result that it was not in their favor, you can see that market dropped within just a week. Market have moved, money flow have moved down from 92.44 to 43. It tells you that funds are really flying out of the market, and these people are leaving for what? For safety. Because I'm telling you, foreign investors at any time, they don't wait. Whether they are making loss, capital is king. That is why you and I should also adopt a strategy that our stop loss should not toy with it. Play with your don't play with your stop loss. Once you touch it, exit, because it is when you have capital that you can play the market. It is when you have the capital that you can play the market. Without capital, there's nothing you can do in the market. But before I go to the weekly time frame for us to round up, don't look at the down slope from here to here. Market breakout and cross the 20 days moving average, which is still strong. And as we speak now, market is still above 20 days moving average. Good. And you can see that the money flow index is flat here at 45.08, which is still low. Looking at where it were when the market was at the peak, it was almost then at 75. But look at where it is today. You need to really look at this money flow when you are taking investment decision. On this note, we look forward to see you at the coming seminar in Abuja on the 23rd of March. There we'll be looking at the 30 stocks for 2019 that has great momentum that you can go there and sleep for the year. This part of what we're going to discuss in Abuja, and at that Abuja program, how you can take advantage of the bulls and the bears that we're expecting in 2019. Already, you can see that the bulls and fear and the bears, they are always fighting each other since the beginning of the year. Then how can you take advantage of the bulls and the bear to make money, or what, to increase your income or to protect your capital? You need to understand how to consider these two, bull and bear, in the market to know when to be in stocks and when to be out of stock. We'll draw the curtain here today. By next week, as we're looking at the market performance, but our outlook for the new week we are entering, before I draw the curtain, sorry, the outlook for the new week, we expect a missed performance depending on the number that are released to the market during the week. You saw what happened the previous week, that when the blue chips come out, the high contracts were released, it was how the market reacted to it. That is likely to be the pattern, but I see a miss, what performance in the new month, the same trend to repeat itself, knowing that by Friday we're expecting the inflation for the month of February to be in the market, and this inflation figure is also going to give us insight how the economy has performed for that period. For me, I see market oscillating between now and the end of any season, but you take advantage of the numbers and take dividend income and also position in stocks that have good fundamentals. See you, and God bless you.